6 years of searching. Please let this be it.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Let me introduce myself. My name is Dani Sofie Nuriza. You can call me Dani. I'm from 12 Science 1. And no, I will analyze movie titled Raya and the Last Dragon.
Each land is named after a part of the dragon. Fang, heart, spine, tail, and talon. We were once unified harmoniously as one until evil forces were awakened, shattering the peace and dividing the five lands. Raya, this isn't the world I want you to live in.
Okay, and the first I will review movie Raya and the Last Dragons. Once upon a time, there was a fantasy world called Kumandra, where humans and dragons live together peacefully. However, once an evil force came and threatened Kumandra's life, the dragons sacrificed themselves to save humanity. Now, 500 years later, the same evil has returned, and the current state of affairs depends on a warrior. Raya, she is trying to find the last legendary dragon to restore the condition of Kumandra and the people who have been cast to stone. However, along his journey to save Kumandra, she will learn that much is needed apart from needing a legendary dragon to save Kumandra once. They also need trust in each other and teamwork. 5 long centuries after the silver sacrifice of a magical dragon, the once peaceful land of Kumandra, where humans lived in harmony with mythical creatures, turned into chaos and divided into 5 countries, with warring factions, mysterious and unstoppable threat of Dran, evil force, wreaking havoc on Kumandra. Raya, a princess from the heartland of the sword-wielding and a fearless guardian of the dragon gem, embarks on a quest for many dangers to find a mythical creature who is kingdom can heal the land of Kumandra. Finally, all the dragons are brought back to life to help them restore the land of Kumandra. Sisu, the last dragon, thanks Ryan, her friends, for trusting others. Everyone is back together again with their family. Raya returns home the ruined with her father, Benja. Then he introduces her to Sisu, the last dragon. At the same time, all the tribes gathered peacefully to celebrate. Okay, and the next, the characteristic. And the first character, Raya. Raya is a swordsman tasked with guarding dragon games with her father's Benja, the leader of the land of Hearth. However, Raya's life was instantly shattered when the jewel that she was guarding was damaged and made her father turn into stone. No, Raya must carry out his mission to save the world. Raya grew into a formidable swordsman with intelligence as sharp as his swords. And the next, Sisu. Sisu Datu or Sisu is the last dragon figure of Kumandra. Legend has it, Sisu is an extremely beautiful aquatic creature with invisible magic power. However, what Raya encountered was different. Sisu was a humorous, funny dragon. Sisu always said she was the least accomplished dragon. Now, Sisu must learn to become the great dragon mentioned in the legend so that she can save Kumandra with Raya. And the next, Namari. Namari was Raya's enemy since childhood. She is a smart warrior, full of planning and thoughts. She is the daughter of the leader of Fang Country. She was ready to do anything to protect her society. However, in her deep down, she had a love for the Sisu dragon. And next, Bon. Bon is a street kid from the land of Tile who is recruited to mentor by premature Sir Suntens and smart to the business. He was the owner, manager, chef, and captain of his ship Shrimporium, However, in his deep down, Bond was a brittle child. He lost his parents because of an attack by an evil force. And five, Little Noi. After losing her parents to drug, 2 years old, Little Noi is fostered by Ongis. Is the trading part of Talon, Little Noi often triggers crowds and distracts pedestrians with her funny behavior. When Little Noi is in action, Ongis swiftly steals their treasure. And next, Tuk-Tuk. Tuk-Tuk is an adorable animal. He was made into a vehicle by Raya. Tuk-Tuk has been a good friend of Raya since he was still as big as her hand. Now, both of them grow up and Tuk-Tuk has become a dashing horse who is loyal to the side of Raya. They together explore the various terrains of Kumandra, are met with a mission to find the last dragon and save the world. And 7, Ongis. Ongis are a group of deceitful animals, shaped like monkeys. They are sneaky and come from the trading port of Talon country. The three of them always live together, including in Rising Noi, a 2-year-old toddler. And next, Benja. Benja is Raya's father and the guardian of the legendary dragon game. As the leader of the Land of Heart, he is an idealist and visionary who believes that the destruction of Kumandra is caused by the action of people from various countries who do not trust each other. Benja seeks to reunite the fractured kingdom of Kumandra and restore harmony as usual. And I, Firana. Firana is the mother of Namari. She was a beautiful and authoritative legend of Fang country. Firana is a portrait of a strong leader, intelligent, distrustful of myths, and always putting feelings aside. Firana believes that cruel acts are the only way to ensure the survival of her society. Annex Tong. Behind is dashing, fast, and terrifying appearance, Tong is a carpenter who enjoys playing with toddlers. The balance between his heart and compassionate nature made Tong known as a gentle giant figure. And the last character, Dran. Dran is a formless, delicious spirit figure who possesses a destructive soul caused by human conflict. With just one touch, they are able to turn humans into stones and multiply themselves. Dran can be blocked by water, but it can only be destroyed by the power of dragon. And the next review idiom. First, go to west. In contextual meaning, this idiom has the meaning of a barren and broken land of Kumandra. And second, Wildfire. According to Merriam-Webster, this dictionary Wildfire is the meaning very rapid lie. This idiom spoken by Raya. She tells that a dangerous plague that attacked Kumandra and turned everyone to stone. And next, wait a second. The idiom wait a second is said by young Raya when she talked with herself. Wait a second means to pause for a moment. And next, beat up. Beat up is an adjective which means in bad condition or despicable. In other words, beat up is self-blame. And next, they drop. This idiom based on story, the use of idiom they drop is father's favorite nickname for her son Raya. And the last, stand up. Stand up means to be in an upright position on your feet.